In case you are wondering if you can run CHR on VMware, then yes you can. I wanted to demonstrate it on Manjaro, but I found that getting VMware to work correctly was almost impossible as there is no official release for ARC-based distributions. Personally, I would just use Qemu anyway. And if you are on Linux too, I would suggest doing that instead. Just watch the video where I explain the Qemu setup. The following is for Windows users. Just go to the VMware homepage and download VMware. Then, when you try to install it, on the first attempt, there is a pop-up asking to reboot the system. So just do that and launch the installation again. The enhanced keyboard driver sounds fancy, so I will happily give up 10 megabytes for it. But I will skip on the customer experience program, even though it might be a club for distinguished gentlemen. Then after the installation, it will probably ask you to upgrade and reboot the system one more time. Once that is done, it is time to go to MikroTik.com download section, look up cloud hosted router and find the OVA template in the list and pick the latest stable version 7. On the VMware player, click the Open a Virtual Machine button and select the OVA image we just downloaded. Give it a name and click Import. In this state, the CHR has only 160 MB of RAM, so we want to edit the virtual machine settings. Give it something around a gigabyte. The rule of thumb is the more interfaces and the more cores, the more RAM you will need if you are going to be using the CHR actively. In this case, I will just give it 4 cores. I will also expand the hard disk to around 500 MB, which should be more than enough. Now there is one network adapter which is bridged to the host's adapter, which means the virtual machine would be in the same local network as your computer. In this case, we will change it to NAT so that a DHCP server is running on our host and it hands out an IP address to the CHR, which will then be able to access the internet and other local networks using the network address translation. If we now run the virtual machine, we can see that it has obtained an IP address and we can use it to open the router's web interface to change settings or use the terminal. Of course, you can also use that very same IP address for other services like Winbox, SSH, and Telnet as well. Now, you might have noticed that we only have a single Ethernet interface. This is because the virtual machine only has a single network adapter. So if we shut down the machine and edit the settings again, you can see that there is an add button under the hardware list. Just click it and choose the network adapter to add another interface. Now this time you do not want it to be bridged or NATed to the host. Most likely you will want to play with some networking setup where you connect this interface to some other virtual machine. So in that case, choose the custom option and then you can pick a specific virtual network that you would like to share with this other virtual machine. So if I boot into the CHR again, I can see that I have two interfaces, but only one has an IP address assigned as the other interface does not have anything at the other end. Note that by default, CHR has a DHCP client pre-configured on Ether 1. So when you connect your other interfaces to other VMs, you will need to configure the IP addressing as well, whether you do it through DHCP or manually. That is about all you need to know to run CHR on VMware. Take care. Bye.